Hello, everybody. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Monica. I'm a salon owner, business owner, entrepreneur, fitness enthusiast, all of the above. Today, I wanted to show you guys how I do a full foilayage on somebody with thick, dark hair. Her hair is virgin. We're going to be doing a dimensional beigey on the ashier side foilayage. I'm going to be showing you guys how I mix the technique and the toning. So if you're interested in seeing that, just keep on watching. Okay guys, so this is our model for today. Her name is Michelle. She's never ever dyed her hair. She has virgin hair. It's super long, it's super thick. So I wanna show you guys how to do a foilage on long, thick, dark hair. I'm gonna be doing a dimensional foilage with a money piece. So it's gonna give her the balayage look, but with a foilage technique. So it's not gonna be hand painted. We're gonna do a bunch of baby lights, a bunch of teasy lights, things like that. And yeah, it's gonna look amazing. We're gonna give her a nice, thick money piece. Let me show you guys the front. Gonna give her nice dimension throughout. And I'll show you guys the whole process and how we achieve it. Here it is. I'm super excited.
Okay guys, so I'm in the back and I'm getting ready to mix her lightener. I'm gonna be using Blondem by Schwarzkopf. It is my favorite lightener, especially for dark, thick hair like hers. It lifts very evenly and quickly. And I'm also gonna be using Olaplex for extra protection. Olaplex is a bond builder, so it helps prevent damage in the hair. And it's something that I put into the bleach. So what I tell people is essentially when you lighten your hair with bleach, you're punching holes into the hair strand to allow light to be seen through. This is what causes the dryness, the breakage, the damage. Olaplex will go in and refill these holes with artificial bonds and help replace the broken bonds in the hair as well. So it helps really protect the hair from all that damage. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and mix all that and then we'll get started.
I like to keep my lightener in these cute little mason jars. Just adds to the aesthetic. And I'm gonna start off with probably like a scoop and a half. She has a lot of hair, so you always want to make sure that your lightener is fresh. So start off with a little bit and then just keep remixing. And I'm gonna probably start with 10 volume. So to make 10 volume, I'm going to mix a little bit of 7 volume and 20 volume. Mainly just 7 volume. And I don't really measure, I kind of just go by consistency just because that's what feels comfortable to me. That's how I've always done it. But you can do whatever feels right for you. Here's the Olaplex. The 7 volume.
And then you always want to add your Olaplex after you mix up your lightener. That's just the instructions. And I'm going to, since I did about a scoop and a half, I'm going to add about 1/8 of an ounce. And then mix that in as well. And for my consistency, I just like it to be a little less thick than toothpaste. So I don't want it to be like really, really stiff, because then when it's too thick, I feel like it doesn't, it's harder to apply. It's just a lot more arm work. But if you get that perfect consistency, it lifts very well while also being extremely smooth and easy to apply, especially with Blondem. Just like this. So this is perfect.
So with guests, I always like to leave their hair parted where they actually part their hair. That way you can see like your placement and where it's gonna be. And I always like to have pretty good clean sections. I always say clean sections, clean work. Some people would not agree, but that's just the way I think. I separate this triangle piece because this is the hair that falls over the head like that. So I wanna make sure that I have a bunch of baby lights up here and stuff like that if the client wants it up close to the root. I always like to look at the hairline under here and see what kind of shape they have. And then based off of that, I'll start my foils either like this or like this. For her, she kind of has a very like angled hairline here, so I'm gonna start diagonally here. So when she puts her hair up, you can see some blonde and some nice baby lights and dimension. So
I'm gonna start here with some teasy lights. So her hair under here is pretty fine compared to the rest of her hair, so we can take a little bit of a bigger section. But she does have thick, thick hair, and a lot of it is just a little less thick under here. I always make sure that my teasing is very tight too. You don't want to have it super like, you know, like messed up, and then we want to keep it really clean. I'm going to be using Framar's roll foil, this one right here. It allows you to cut your own length. Fold it a little bit. And you want to make sure that you're saturating really well, always, always. That is why I take it like this. And when I get up here, kind of brush up a little bit. And that's our first foil. So I'm gonna do a couple more teasy lights like that. Probably like two more and then switch to the other side.
You'll see parts that don't have lightener. That's why you really want to go in and dazzle it up. We'll do the same thing, three foils, going along with the angle of her hairline. So this is kind of like a low light for dimension. Here, so you have all your triangle pieces here. That's her hairline. Here, we're just gonna do a tiny little section like that. And then same thing, take some teasy lights, leave some dimension, tease. And when I tease it, I don't like to hold it too tight, because then it doesn't allow for like an easy tease. Just like medium tension. And then bring it all the way up, make sure it's tight. Grab it here. Probably do either one more or two more. And then this is where I'll probably start taking thicker slices, just because I want it to be pretty dimensional. I don't want it to look like highlights. So after this, going up, we'll take bigger sections. I like to do smaller sections around the hairline so it looks softer, especially when she puts her hair up. You do put your hair up a lot for work, right? Yeah. She's a lot fair, so she puts her hair up a lot. So we don't want it to look like really dark. This is like half an inch section, a little bit less than half an inch. So that way you see a bigger low light.
our first bowl of lightener. I'm gonna go mix up more. Like I said, you wanna make sure that the bleach is always fresh, so it's better to keep mixing instead of, you know, mixing a whole lot and having it sit there and, you know, oxidize.
We're on bowl number four, and I'm getting ready to do this triangle piece. This is the piece that lays on the top part of her hair, so it's the most visible. So I'm basically going to do the same thing, take teasy lights going up the head like this. I'm not going to be doing any baby lights here, just because I want her to have dimension, and I don't want it to look like, I don't want it to be too up high. Her hair is really dark, so I want her to have like a softer grow. So for this front piece, she parts her hair practically in the middle, a little bit off center, but I usually like to take triangle sections. I like a really noticeable money piece. It's in style, so we're gonna give her something a little thick. So for the first couple of foils, I don't really like to tease. I like to just kind of do like a sliced, either a baby light like this or a sliced baby light. I'm gonna do a slice. So I'll do about 3 or 4 slices back to back, and that's gonna give her the highest point in the front. So it's gonna be as close as possible to the root. So now I'm gonna start taking thin teasy lights. Thank you. So now I'm gonna start working around her hairline here. I'm gonna take thinner sections here so we can have lighter pieces towards the front. Again, probably gonna do a teasy light. I don't want it all the way to her root anywhere, only probably here in the front. Oh no. So making sure that it's tight so it's not messy. And I like to angle the foil because it keeps it clean and it makes it easier to apply the lightener. Another little trick that I like to use is here towards the front, since we want it to be lighter towards the money piece, we take thinner weaves and then we get thicker towards the back. Kind of like this. Thinner and then thicker. And I always like to start teasing from the bottom all the way up like this. Because if you tease right here, you're still going to have that line of demarcation. So I'm gonna do that all the way to the top of the head, and then I'm gonna show you guys the other side as well. We are on bowl number 5 or 6. I lost count. But 6, right?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Crazy. Let me do, I think we're only gonna need one more. So we're good. So my camera battery died. I didn't know that you needed to get multiple battery packs if you were gonna be recording for longer than a couple of hours. So here we are using my iPhone yet again. So I'm gonna do the other side, same thing. Okay, so this is how we look right now, pre-toner. It looks super good already, and the money piece looks amazing. So I'm gonna show you guys what toners I'm gonna mix. 3N Shades of Cute for her shadow root. Okay. For the rest of her hair, I'm gonna be mixing 8GN, 6GN, and 7V. So it's gonna be like a 7GN and 7V together. So I'm aiming for a level 7, but it's probably gonna be like an 8 because her hair is already at like a level 8-9. So this is her shadow root. And I'm gonna do about an ounce. There we go, making a mess. Oh my god, that happened in the last video too. Ah! I'm gonna mix that and then show you guys how I apply it, and then I'm gonna mix this after. Here is our shadow root mixture. I'm gonna show you guys how I do this. Basically, everything needs to go on an angle. I'm gonna do about this much shadow root.
You always want to do a little bit more than what you think you need for the shadow root. So I take front to back, ear to ear, and then down the middle back here, blocking the camera. And this is how I do it. So I take angled sections. Making sure that it's really saturated. Now I'm going to take the wild comb section by section, trying to drag down the shadow root a little bit to give it that extra blend, but I'm going to make sure that her hair is fully detangled before I do that, so the comb doesn't get stuck anywhere. So I'm going to take smaller sections, I'm going to do this all over. So now I'm gonna go ahead and get the other toner mixed up for her. Half an ounce of 6GN, half an ounce of 8GN to make 7GN. And then she has a lot of hair, so I'm probably gonna do a full ounce of 7B. Processing solution. Equal parts. Mix that well. And I'm not gonna put it on her money piece until the very end. So I'm gonna leave this for about 10 minutes and I'm only gonna put it on the money piece for the last minute or two. I'm gonna also use the wow comb to blend it all in. I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing to the other side. Okay guys, we are done. We didn't have time to curl her hair, unfortunately, because I lost my driver's license a couple months ago and I have an appointment coming up, so we gotta make it to the DMV on time. But I did flat iron it, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys and show her as well.
It looks so good.
Oh my god, that's so pretty on you. Look at that. Ah, I wish the lighting was better with the camera. That's better. The lighting is so yellow in here.
I love it.
Look at that. It's so pretty. It's like a beige. And then the money piece. Look at the money piece, y'all. It's fire. Turn this way. And this is the back.
It looks so good. That's so pretty.
So this is our final result. She has a really pretty beige foilayage now. I wish we would have had time to curl it, But this is what it looks like. Take a step forward again. You're tall. So it's super pretty, nice and dimensional, and ashy. Make sure you guys, so pretty. And she has never dyed her hair before, so this is her very first time. Gorgeous.
This is gonna look so good curled. This looks bomb. The main piece is giving me life.
How do you like it?
I love it. It's so good.
Yay. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I hope that I was able to help you all learn something or learn a new trick, a new technique. Let me know what you guys want to see from me next in the comments. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm so sorry that we were not able to curl it either. I didn't make it to my appointment on time anyways. I might as well just have curled it. But it's okay. We'll do it next time. It still looks really good straight. Thank you guys for watching. Bye.